Then we will hit from Ellen G. White and the ministry of Ellen G. White and the Miralize movement, and the list will go on.
Yebeko Akosia Ara White and the Millerites more addition.
This afternoon we will take 2 hours to watch a film about how the Seventh-day Adventist Church commenced.
So wherever
I will end from this presentation, the film will take it from
there.
So if you have anywhere to go, and you want to call yourself a Seventh-day Adventist, I will kindly plead with you that you spend those precious hours, just to, I think, 1 hour, 45 minutes, with us here this afternoon. And what we watch this afternoon will be like the apogee, the climax, and the transition between the Bible and the Seventh-day Adventist movement.
Now, the open way,
this very moment, we are going to work on guidance in crisis. We are going to run through the Bible and how the Lord revealed himself through a lot of prophets.
Anytime
that the children of Israel were in trouble, how God will bring out a prophet. And we work on the intertestamental period, the period between the New Testament and the Old Testament and the New Testament as well. Then, when we get to the book of Revelation, the question will be, what next? Are you following me here? The question would be, what next? From Genesis through to Revelation, what next?
And the question, as some of you say, if we, most of you may think, I go see a piece of material, at the end of us.
I believe that you thank your God that he has given you that privilege to be a Seventh-day Adventist.
But on
your
heads
and let us pray. Oh, gracious Lord, we thank you again for this moment. Thus far, you have been leading us through this series. We believe that again you put my side and talk to your holy angels, your holy people who are longing to hear your word. Gracious Lord, speak to us. We pray this in your holy name. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, you my Bible is somewhere there. Please give me the Bible. I think I would have told you this story before, that once I was in Norway. And I left England to go there when I was studying at New World College to campus.
Me free New World Echo car and I'm sent to Tom.
And the car that I went with, I can't remember the full car number plate, but the number plate was MPJ.
Now, if you share a bit more, a coy, and a main kind of Indian, as the Navy kind said, MPT, and I want
MPT, it was a very small yellow car. And Pastor Fergus, I remember when I went to buy that car in Bracknell, he looked at the car and the wife was standing there and he said, "Oh, this is yellow sissy."
Now, my car is a brand, got all car, no, also from Fergus, straight car, and I'm a car, it's a yellow sissy.
So I drove the car all the way from here to Norway.
And if you didn't call Norway.
From here to Newcastle, I took the ferry.
If you have seen Newcastle, we'll be trying about Subuntu.
Then from the ferry to Stockholm in Sweden.
I've been through across Stockholm and then across Sweden.
Then I drove the car across Sweden into Norway.
And until we can know every Sweden, any call Norway.
For 3 months, I was working with that car. And it was a typical English car. And as a poor student, as soon as you see me and the car, you can't run away from the car. Everybody knew the car.
Now, just say, English, how lorry.
The exhaust mess itself up, so when we're going out to campus, we'll stay full.
Oh, you can't say
and use it to attach the exhaust before we can go.
Now, what is phone as just by Nazan, what we have to ask?
And as soon as the food be melted, you'll be hearing noise, ton. And
I have to
stop and cool the engine before I'll attach the food. And
then
one day I drove down a steep.
Now that would be me to track and echo super.
I went there, I went to campus in a house, there was nobody there, but the car pumpy cascara. I tried every means possible. I was down a hill in a town called Molde in Norway. And nobody could speak English over there. And while I was down there in the dungeon, I was praying, lo and behold, a young girl of about 8 years old came over.
Now me woke up, Mako Kamala no more do.
And when he came, he saw my predicament, but we could not communicate verbally.
Now, Oba, I bet you know who my real host is. No, never boy. Now, so to me, and me, Kasa.
He saw a poor black student coming from England with a left-handed car, very old. The car can do nothing, and he saw that I was trying to fix the car, but I couldn't.
So all of a sudden,
this little girl left the place and ran wherever that she was going to go to. And next time my head was a noise of a tractor. God is good all the time. And this girl had gone to tell the papa that poor black guy was struggling there, and the man came with a tractor and came to help me out. So our subject for discussing today is guidance in crisis. And even the children of Israel, when they were in trouble in those days, God could use his angels, his prophets, to support them throughout their life. And they journeyed until everything was successful. Now you come to LNG White and the Remnant Church and the Seventh-day Adventist Church, and we are going to see how the Lord is going to help us journey through to that end.
Now we have made you to acquire our control, say a bride and white non-pencil by the soul na every so any.
Mass awareness of the presence of God is the heart of Christianity. We are here because we believe that the Savior is there for us.
Anytime
that you are in need and you feel the presence of God, yes, that tells you that you are a Christian.
And
the promise of Jesus Christ among us.
No wonder
that he told the disciples when he resurrected and they were trying to get hold of him and they could not get hold of him. He said, Lord, I am with you always.
And even if your car is down there,
remember that, Lord, I am with you always.
It's
a solemn but happy assurance and guidance and victory to his children. Because the bottom line is that my Savior has resurrected. And since he has resurrected, it is not only me alone who is in trouble, but when the church at large is in trouble, the church should remember that Jesus says, Lord, I am with you always, in the end of ages.
Amen.
And he is willing to strengthen us.
Now,
that his presence will always overshadow us. However, in scholarly, there's a school of thought they are called the deists. There's a school of thought we call them the deists.
And you be any as you have to be from the dig days.
They believe that God is a personal God. But even though he is a personal God, that he created this whole world and one day is going to judge us, but to him, God is far away. He is not experienced in our day-to-day affair. Either in nature or in history, even though God has created us, he careless. And there's another school called the
Pantheists.
They say that all forces and laws of this existing universe combine to form God. And so the power of electricity, the power of light, and the power of the devil all combine to form God. Although he is everywhere present, but he is impersonal as gravitation or as the rays of the sun.
Now, when you say Yakubo, we be a Nansuan to be a donny or to be a bimoy, because of only.
But to me, as a Seventh day Adventist Christian,
that's so me, I'm here with a
party. And to me, as a Bible Christian,
that may have been the Joseph
God is a personal being to me.
He is
both transcendent and imminent.
Oh, now we want to.
He is exalted above all the world.
Man, so I change, yes,
and he's the supreme ruler of all.
Yes, you know.
And the same God who dwells in this world. And he's my friend and my companion. No wonder he says, call upon me in times of trouble, and I will be there before you. No wonder that the Hebrew writer says, what a friend we have in Jesus Christ. All those who are in trouble, call upon me. No wonder that David could say that, I will lift up my eyes unto the heavens, from whence cometh my help. My help comes from the Lord. Praise the Lord. If you doubt it, you may read the following text.
So
this concept of God is based on this following text. Somebody let us read Psalm 11, verse 4. Psalm 11, verse 4. If you open it before the pastor, you too, you are a pastor, you may read it for me. Somebody there? Okay. The Lord is in his holy temple. The Lord's throne is in heaven. And his eyes behold. His eyelids tell the sons of men. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
He sees you. No wonder that in the dream of
Nebuchadnezzar,
when Daniel was supposed to interpret, In Daniel chapter 2, verse 21.
Daniel 2, 21.
Daniel 2,
21.
We read that.
We can't say.
And he changes the times and the season. Who does this?
Because it's not Emre.
And he removes kings and raises up kings. And he gives wisdom to the wise and knowledge to those who have understanding. And the list will go on and go on and go on and go on. Tell us that in our everyday affairs, in times of need, in times of happiness, in whatever times, we have the living Savior on our side. Oh, church, God is good. Now with this, let us look at the children of Israel. Let's go back to this prophet called
Noah.
We are going to see how the Lord intervened in the affairs of this world. From 120 years before the flood proclaimed the message of the imminence of the destruction of the world by
water.
So by faith, Noah believed whatever the Lord said. As long as 120 years longer than the age of Elder
Babe,
more than that, the whole life span of this prophet, he had to proclaim the goodness of the Lord to the world. Because God wanted to take the children out of trouble. And those who were willing to hear the word of the Lord, at the end of the 120th year, the Lord was able to redeem them from the dungeons of this world. Now let's think of
Abraham.
Oh, and the forming of a nation through whom he planned to make known to the world his love.
Oh no, and our farm, so Emma, if we are saying my friend is that by.
At this time, the children have left the presence of God. And at this moment, in the hour of Cadians, his father, Terah, and the rest were worshipping gods. And from nowhere, God called
him,
that my friend, I will make you the father of all nations. And when the world was in trouble, and the Lord called him in faith, he went. And when his son was old enough, God tested him that he would kill the son to sacrifice.
But
in the name of the Lord, he prays forever and ever.
Amen.
May the name of the Lord be praised forever and ever. And he lifted the knife to kill the son. God said, oh my son Abraham, in this time of crisis, I will provide for you a lamb.
Abraham.
And this lamb represented Jesus Christ. Oh, the Savior who be nailed on the cross. In times of trouble, God is there. And after Abraham came son Joseph.
Abraham came and I nana Joseph.
And you know all the sort of dreams that Joseph was having. And to preserve the nation founded by Abraham,
And this is a period of over two centuries now. And still so small that it could be measured by the size of Jacob's family, I mean the whole nation.
Joseph and Israel, my no.
The Lord raised up another prophet called Prophet Joseph. And Prophet Joseph, in dreams, God used him. When he was going to find food for his own brethren and he was sold. Down there in the pit. And when he was bought by the Amalekites, in the house of Pharaoh,
every Pharaoh went
or in the dreams that he interpreted, in the prison there, until when his father died, and when his brothers thought that they wanted to kill him, turn with me to Genesis chapter 50. Genesis chapter 50.
What's the medical intent you know?
Genesis chapter 50.
What's the medical intent you know?
The first book of the Bible, chapter 50, verses 19 through to 21.
19
through to 21. And now Joseph said to his brother, do not be afraid, for I am in the place of God. But as for you, you meant evil against me. Church, the devil may want to have some trouble for you. But God meant it for good. In order to bring it about as far as this day, to save many people alive. Now the most important test that I like, the 21st verse. Now therefore do not be afraid.
Now Joseph.
But tell the person sitting next to you, hold the person's hand, look at the face of the individual, and tell him that even though your brothers may sell you, now therefore do not be afraid. I will provide for you and your little ones. And comfort them and speak kindly to them, because the goodness of the Lord is good.
If you say,
and when the devil plans something evil for me, change it. Look at his face. Uncle Amos. When people plan something bad for me, when I plan something bad against you, you Amos, God will turn out bad plans of myself, so that I can save
my life.
Praise the Lord. So that person who's planning evil against you, God is telling you that be not be dismayed. Through that bad ways, you will
be
saved the same person. So Prophet Joseph, even though his brothers wanted to sell him, but God through that was able to save his own people. Down from Joseph, you are traveling today, you are traveling. Now from Joseph,
free Joseph, so
is it not going? Me, you and yeah. Okay. Yes. Now we go to Moses. And Moses, his leadership and his preservation.
Moses, Nakani, any Sulukwa or ye no.
Sorry. Sorry. What is happening here? Okay. Now Moses.
Moses. The thing is traveling faster than the pastor, you know. These technologies, they call it technologies. Go back to Moses. Thank you very much. Sorry for the interruption. God called him for leadership and preservation.
Onyame eshede yi no sunko efra no ma ka die.
For 80 years before the time of the release of the children of Israel from bondage,
every shebe adwotwe mu ansa na nyame be fra so me yi Israel for every nkoso mu no.
God prepared his tent.
Onyame eshede ko siesie no.
God called him.
Onyame fra no.
If you read the text over there for me, Amos chapter 13, verse 12, which our brother, our young guy, was about to read for us.
Hosea
12, 13. Let somebody read for us. Hosea 12, 13. Chi.
Okay, I say, now Radinam, Odifo, Asui, Israel, from Israel, bye.
Amen.
Now, Namodifo, Asui, Asher, Amen.
Amen. Amen. The English version, please. By the prophet, the Lord God brought Israel out of Egypt. So he was the leader and he preserved the children of Israel. Remember at the burning bush. God revealed himself to him. Then God called him. Remember that even though he could not go to the promised land, but God promised him something. And before he would die, God will reveal the promised land to him. And when he died, he was buried, and God resurrected him. And he had to go to heaven alive. On the day of transfiguration, when God, Jesus Christ, was in trouble, God brought Moses to console Jesus Christ. Even though your education status may be horrible, but the Lord knows how you would like to capitalize on the situation to give you absolute peace that surpasses all understanding. Oh, Moses, even though he suffered, it was through him that the Lord revealed the Pentateuch. Through Moses, the leader, the messenger of God, the psalmist, the preacher, the guide, the protector, and the worker of miracles. Very importantly, church. When they go to the Red Sea. And Pharaoh and his entourage were en route coming.
Now what you want to know who's at a phone to achieve?
And the mountains were there. And when the children of Israel started mourning,
now Israel
mourning in the church.
Or the Okobobi Masafon.
God.
Unyame.
Could lead the children of Israel through Moses to walk on the promised land. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And through the same system, now that you are in doubt of your life, all these purges of life that you are going through now, God is going to guide you through this crisis that one day when the saints are marching in, you too will be counted among the
numbers.
Then we go to Samuel. Whose time marked the transition from the full-fledged theocracy. Israel voluntarily placed themselves under the God's leadership at Mount Sinai. Moses was privileged to bless the first priest. The first king of Israel was blessed by this gentleman, Samuel. And through him, there were so many wonderful things that the Lord did through the children of
Israel.
And he got to a point of jumping history now. Jumping history that the children of Israel were in trouble. There were some captivities for them. The faith of Judah, the faith of Northern Kingdom, were in trouble. But God tried every means possible through the ministry of Jeremiah, Daniel, Hosea, all these people, so that the children of Israel will be out of their bondage.
When Jeremiah, Daniel,
so that Israel was restored back from their
bondage.
And even though during the time that they were in bondage, God said, Ephraim had joined the idols, let him alone. When you get to the book of Haggai, you see that they have been restored, and the children of Israel were able for 44 years were able to build the temple of the Lord.
What do you say? Israel had the Ephesians 9, 8 Ephesians C, as Emma and
then from here you go to the book of Malachi, and when you get to the book of Malachi, the prophecy ends there.
I feel everyone will see Odifo Malachi. So,
the period of Malachi to the period of Matthew, there's a long break of revelations of the Lord.
And it is over here, every Malachi, Echo see Matthew, and Ansana Matthew, which has you know, if you bring on a normal integrity, a baby.
Are you following me here? There was a gap, but the question is, where was God?
A woman said, not going here up and down here. So, as a minister said, not a young boy.
But God was so kind that he was able to link the Old Testament and the New Testament somehow.
Turn
with me Malachi chapter 3.
This is not
touch an offering matter, so don't worry. Don't put your hand in your pocket.
Malachi
chapter 3. Verse 1.
Jim Bab.
Malachi chapter 3, verse 1.
Malachi Jimmy and said Jim Bab.
We are traveling as a church and we are going to see how the Lord brought your Seventh-day Adventist church into existence.
You took quite a sapo. Now if you see a woman said, you quite a yame pass on the yame after we are eating every day.
Behold, I sent my messenger, and he will prepare the way before me.
And we see it,
and the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant, in whom you delight. Behold, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. Praise the Lord. Now God has restored Israel. There's not going to be major revelations of himself. There will be a lot of prophecies. But in Malachi, God is talking of the ministry of John the Baptist, which will link up with the coming of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Yes.
After they're not ready to Israel, see him. When you're in the shadow, Moses will be to me as he is. Now, so he's Now, Jebabia, all who says he would give for a friend, Johannes, when you know.
Therefore, in chapter 4 of Malachi, verse 5,
and until 9, Jimunum, El Malachi,
behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet
before
the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
And
he will tear the hearts of fathers to the children, and the hearts of the children to their fathers, lest I come and strike the earth with a curse. Talking of the ministry of Elijah, comparing it with that of John, because of time, I will not have time to exegete
there.
Then we jump to Matthew. I've spoken of John the Baptist and away. Then we jump to Paul. The ministry of Paul, because of time, anybody who needs this, I'll give it to you.
Paul.
I don't want to mess this up here, but okay. After John, then we go to Paul.
If you had a place or not, if it
through Paul, Paul was not only to be an apostle but also a prophet.
Paul, not only was a pagan, could not say a default.
A message was sent to the Hebrew Christians to direct their attention to Christ as the high priest and the in the heavenly sanctuary.
You
know how Israel, Paul, and you know all those stories and the wonderful things that Paul. God used Paul to do during the New Testament times, that he would even write so many books for those who were Jews and non-Jews as well.
Then
we jump to the book of Revelation. Then on Patmos, we know, you and I know, how the Lord reveal the history of Christianity through John. In verse 1 of the first chapter, the revelation of Jesus Christ, which he told of the things which must shortly come to pass. Some things were about to come to pass. Uncle, I'm not mentioning your name if you are sleeping. Yeah. So let us say that you are never sleeping. Uncle, are you sleeping? It's not you. But somebody is sleeping. I won't mention your name. Yeah. Praise the Lord. So nobody is sleeping. I never said that you are sleeping. Because I've rushed you through. At least you've gotten the gist that God has been leading his church from Genesis, and we are now in Revelation.
And
now the operation of the prophetic gift was to continue to the close of New Testament times. So in the New Testament time to prophecy was being mentioned. And you will see that Christ plays in the church certain gifts, including the gift of prophecy that he intended to continue to function until the second coming. Do you understand? At least here. Are you following me here? God still has the spirit of prophecy after the New Testament time, even till today. God has given all of us various gifts in the church. The gift of preaching and teaching, the gift of interpreting, the gift of singing and playing, and the gift of childbearing, praise the Lord,
amen.
And the gift of drinking tears, whatever. But the bottom line is, I just use that so that I can get your attention. But the bottom line is, this is very important.
until Jesus comes.
I don't want them to pass a mission and say, where we are, and what is a Jesus Christ over there?
That's why I'm saying that we're going to watch something from here this afternoon.
But what I say,
until Jesus comes,
and what is a Jesus over there?
Prophecy should be manifested in his church.
Is that glad?
Aside from that, if that spirit were not to be there, we'll be in trouble. All these prophets that I have been mentioning their names, they only come when the children of Israel were in trouble. In the New Testament time, when there were only 12 of the disciples who turned 120,
on the
day of Pentecost, God rained his spirit on his children. They could preach, and on that day, the sermon that Peter preached, he got 3,000 souls into the kingdom of God. And on the way to Damascus, God called Paul, said, Paul, why do you persecute me?
Now, Paul, a brother of Damascus, I compare as you have with your children, you have been your friends, Paul,
and God called him to be his prophet.
Now, of a so friend on MAFD for.
And the list will go on until that in 1 Corinthians, we are told that the gift is darkness.
Now, and the children of Koswa,
important for the church is the gift of prophecy. A period of silence occurred as a result of the apostasy and spiritual darkness. Of those centuries, manifestation of prophetic gifts were either limited or only in their local area.
So those periods,
in fact, if you read from 1 Samuel chapter 3, you will see that because of sin, God did not reveal himself to the children of Israel a lot.
And you say, okay, Samuel, you may take a TV and son of Eddie Connor. What do you say? Bonity, when you may say that I ain't getting
my baby. Every time that the world goes into apostasy,
and
the Lord limits his revelation. But every time you are in trouble, whenever you are in crisis, God will pave the way for you. In the last days, the remnant church has a particular need of this gift. Why? Because we are in times of trouble.
Satan is saying, yeah, or how brave.
In the increase of prophetic revelation seems to be linked to the increased attention to the will of God. So now that we have acknowledged this, all those who are saying that really we need a prophetic gift in our life so that in times of crisis, God will attend to us, raise up your hand.
What I would say,
those who are saying that our lives have been messed up and things are very difficult for us, so that in this crisis, we need a savior, I will kindly request you to stand up.
Yeah, no more, you super anti. One day, a dry and a name, I might name Temutiti, and you will say, yeah, Yame, and Temina for us every.
First, you would like the Lord to lead you out of this burden of crisis that you are in. And that God Himself should reveal Himself to you in times of trouble. We are rich, the part of the world in the history of Christianity, that where we are at the point
But we are true, be a beer.
That in no time the Savior is going to come.
And Chebia, and you want me to be a
but in this crisis period,
then so of how pray we?
God should first reveal Himself to you.
It does not be a decay, a you want the NHL.
And then He reveals Himself to His church.
Now, when you want the NHL, Nasafu.
God is the joy and the strength of my life. He removes all pain, misery, and strife. He promised to keep me, never to leave me. He'll never ever fall short of His word. Oh God, I fast and pray, stay in the narrow way, and keep my life clean every day. I want to go with Him when He comes back. I've come too far and I'll never turn back. God is, God is, God.
Asafua,
I pray, God,
that you have a chance of experiencing this special gift of God. That in your trouble, He will give you peace. Oh God, we thank you again. From the wilderness to troubles, you've led your church. Through prophets, oh God, you've led your church. When the burdens are too much for us to bear, oh God, you've shown your face. Really, you are God. Really, that was thank you. Thank you. May your name continue to be praised forever and ever. Whatever burdens that you are carrying within us, oh God, give us peace. That surpasses our understanding. We pray this in your holy name.
Amen.
So please, you can really understand where you are if you are able to watch this show that we want to watch this afternoon.
Amen.
And I'm saying to me, best friend, say, a whole world of any kind, and Koji and the Asan Toma, Yako, it's a warm community are powerful, you beating our Atonium, Emra, or more AJ and the end.
Before we sing our closing hymn now, the announcement is the couples, Mr. and Mrs. Amoa, has provided some snack for the church. The order is the visitors first, then the church will be. But guests will remain on their seat and be singing for us while we are collecting the drinks. Amen.
When Yamba and Macron and Sonya and from it up, I know I had no any drinks here.
Shall we all stand up? Yes. In 6, 2, 4, 6. 2, 1, 6.